Many sellers on Wayfair find it really difficult to list items, especially when they have many items to list. But what if I tell you there is a faster and smarter way? The solution here is to use a feed file. But if you don't know how to use feed file, don't worry. In this video, I am breaking down how to use a feed file to upload products in bulk, saving you time, energy, and frustration. Two ways you can list item on Wayfair. First one is manually, you list single item one at a time, and the other one is using a feed file. For the manual listing, we have a video on it. Go check this out. I will give you the link in the description below. However, you as a seller have tons of items to sell, so single listing would take forever, right? Here, feed file comes in to save your time and hassles. You list all the items in a single spreadsheet and then upload. But how you can do this? If I show you, go to the Wayfair dashboard and from the quick links, click on add new products. Now you see these options. Here, the first one is standard product. This is newly added in the system. We can use this to download the template and then list item on it. The process is pretty straightforward. But the tricky part with the standard product option is that you must enter accurate data. If there is an error, the file gets rejected and you will need to fix the issue and re-upload it to finish. In the older version though, the file would upload first, add your listing and let you fix errors later. I'll break down the whole process. It's up to you what method you're gonna use. But I would suggest that you should get used to standard product option because the older method might be removed soon. Anyway, click next and from here download the template. First, we need to select the categories. Based on what category you select, the template will generate. Now, click on the download template. Our file is downloaded. This is the template, and here you get the instruction. If you're gonna list your product by yourself, then make sure you read the instruction properly. Anyway, this is where we're gonna add our data. You can see the required additional and conditional. All the required column must be filled, otherwise the system will reject the file when you're gonna upload it. Additional. This you can skip if you do not have any data available. And the conditional, it depends on what data you input in your required field. However, the first segment is basic information we need to fill up from this row. So fill up your supplier part number, brand. Here you can see the drop down. You can select the brand from here. Your manufacturer part number in this column, and the next UPC code, product's name, collection name. This is additional, you can skip. Same for the manufactured product URL. Now pricing, put your base price here, and these two are optional. The next step is marketing information, fill up such as marketing copy and 5 feature bullets, and this is fulfillment information segment. Fill up your minimum order quantity, force quantity multiplier, display set quantity, and all the required ones. And then fill up cartoon details in this segment like weight, height, width, depth, etc. Now, compliance segment, first is warning required. If your product have warning for proposition 65, click yes or no from here, and based on your answer, fill up all these columns. Now select what is your country of manufacturer. You can add images here. All you have to add URL. Also, if you want to add videos, put your URL links here in this column. And now documents such as product certification, owner manuals, warranty information, delivery information, etc., etc. Now in this segment, we need to add attributes such as set, product type, materials, etc. After filling all this, save the file and upload it here. And that's it. Your product will be listed successfully. Now let's see the older process. Okay, for that, we need to click here for the older version. Now click SQ edition. Select the brand. Here you can see download blank template. as we are adding new products, have to click on this. And you see these two options right now, product sheets only and product sheet with class specific details. First one is the general template, so I am stick with this and download the template. Well, in this template, we already updated the data you are seeing here, and here if you see the Excel file, the process is pretty much same, like all the red column are the required one must have to fill and all the optional can be skipped. However, fill up the columns such as manufacturer model number, supplier part number, product name, your base cost here, minimum order quantity, force multiple, display set quantity, etc. etc. Here, this is the marketing copy, feature bullet, images, URL, and all this. I know you got this already, so fill up according to your data. Now, save the file and upload it here. This will take a while to upload. Alright, the upload is done. Now, if I scroll below, here you can see the product list. The process is not finished yet. We have to go through each segment like we do in the manual process to make sure all the data we given are correct. We can change it if not. If I click on next, see this warning? Says that UPC code is missing. As in the template, this is optional, so we skipped it, right? However, you can continue by clicking this. In the media section, we can see the image we added in the template. These are the videos we added. And these are the documents we added in the template. Now, in this classing section, you can see that our product are not classified yet. So, select all and click on this. Now, select the categories. Okay, that's done. And the further process we explained in the first video, you can check this out. Now, I'm gonna fast forward this. Okay, that's done. The last step is review. So review all the product that upload using feed file. If all is okay, now click submit project. And that's done. Your product is successfully listed in Wayfair. Yeah, the process is pretty lengthy and might seem tough, but if you follow the process, you can easily list item properly. If you have any question about this, let us know in the comment below. Also, you can email us at info@ecomclips.com. That's all for today. I hope you found this video helpful. If so, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay tuned.